Good morning, Bowflex family. I'm Amy, and today we are doing a live 30-minute kettlebell sculpt workout. So full body workout. We're gonna get it all in 30 minutes. We'll get strength, we'll get cardio, we'll get some core, and we'll be using just one kettlebell. I'll be using my Bowflex adjustable kettlebell. So if you have that, we can switch between different weights. If you have options to go a little heavier or a little lighter, it's always good to have those close by. Otherwise, just one kettlebell or one weight, or just show up and move your body. All right, let's go ahead and get started. You can start just by marching or jogging, whatever feels good for you. We'll get a quick little warm up to get the blood flowing, get our muscles warm, get everything moving. Maybe you're just waking up like me. Whew, waking up those muscles, I should say. Whew. So let's get it going. It's Monday morning. I hope you had a great weekend and you are ready to move today and get that energy up. You can make those arm swings a little bit bigger. And then let's just take it up and down, add a little hinge. Obviously, we're gonna do this hinge movement with our swings, so always good to warm up through the back of the body. Let's swing those arms over and under, big stretch, open it up. So total body workout today, sculpting, so we'll have a little extra focus on that toning and that strengthening, but of course, because we're gonna move quickly, we'll be getting that heart rate up for cardio as well. You can reach those arms up, open up to the side, little mobility work as we're getting ready to use the weight. Take it here, flat back down, and round it up. Again, always good to warm up along the spine before we get into those swings. As always, I will give you lots of different options. Let's hold it here. Depending on your fitness level and where you are today, I want you to work to your level. I'm gonna give you some options. You always can take a low impact option for whatever reason. Walk those feet in, round it up, tap and reach across. And I'll give you some options to take it up if you are ready for another challenge, but it is totally up to you. I'm just happy that you showed up and you are moving with me. I always say, if you showed up today, you are successful. So thank you for being here. Go ahead and bring those hamstrings to the back. Pull those elbows back. Yes. And hands up to the top. I always think I don't need that much of a warm up, but once I start doing it, I can tell. Really good to get the movement in, get the mobility work. Let's take those knees across, so we feel warm and ready to go. You don't need much, but it is important. And then let's stretch those legs out to the front. Good, good. All right, so this is a no repeat workout today, so get excited about that. We are gonna be moving through things pretty quickly. We'll be working strength and muscle endurance. Go ahead and step touch. Let's keep it going. I will show you your first couple moves. We'll get right into it. We'll be working in circuits where you get lower body, then upper body, then core. And in the in-between, while I preview your next moves, I'll give you a little cardio interval if you want to take it, just like this. So you can keep this little step touch or little step hop. Watch me for your first set of moves. So I'm going to grab my kettlebell. I'm going to start on 15. Oh, right there. So we're gonna start with a regular lunge. So we're gonna start stationary. If you need to, you can make it a smaller range of motion. If you can, I want you to get all the way down. Then we'll take it to some moving lunges, reverse lunges. Then we'll add some pulses at the end. We'll stay on this side. We'll take it to our regular row. We'll mix up our angles. We'll add some pulses at the end. Then we'll get all of that in the other side. We'll take it down for some core. So go ahead. Grab your kettlebell, put it on one side, opposite foot forward. We're gonna start here, here we go. Drop it down, zip up in that core. And anytime we have the kettlebell on one side, sometimes we call that offset if it's over our head, it's gonna pull our balance a little bit. So that's where we're gonna really wanna use that core, making sure we're not letting it pull us this way, really stabilize, in the center. Push through that front heel. Breathe. And then watch me here. We're going to lunge it down, step it up. So think of it as a step up or a reverse lunge. We're just pushing through. Again, a little bit longer sets for muscle endurance, but you're gonna like how it feels. Keep breathing. Two more just like this. And then I want you to hold it down here, just pulses. Really low if you can, push into that front heel, stabilize in the core. 4, 3, 2, yes, shake that out. Go ahead and keep that same foot forward. Hopefully that heart is pumping a little bit. You can stagger it just a bit. Kettlebell in the center. We're gonna do a row. So bring it up and drop it down. I like to stagger a little bit, but it's up to you. If you wanna be more parallel, as long as you can keep that back flat, not rounding here, elbow up, squeeze in the shoulder blade, right? All through the back. Good. Now we're gonna rotate it out. So pull wide if you can. If for some reason that's too heavy or too much, you can keep that regular row. But if you can, let's take it wide. Three more just like this. Yes. Now I want you to bring it back in, little pulses. So you're pulsing that elbow up, squeezing in the shoulder blade. Keep breathing. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, drop it down. Give your hand a little break. I know that's a long time to hold it. Little taps out. So we're gonna get all of that on the other side. Starting with our regular lunge, we'll step into it, reverse, and then we will pulse it at the top, and then we'll take it to those rows. So zip up in that core, grab that kettlebell, drop it down. Here we go. Keep everything engaged. And again, making sure we're keeping that kettlebell from pulling us to the side. Breathe. Good. And then step back into it. So reverse lunge, or you can also just think of it as a step up where you're pushing out of that heel as you come up, kettlebell down to the side. Keep breathing. Woo! Little bit of balance. So if you need to hang on to something, the wall or a chair or the couch, that works too. Good. And let's hold it down right here. Just pulse into that heel. Breathe. Yes. 4, 3, 2. Relax. Shake that out. I'm feeling it. I hope you are too. Flat back, keep it in that same hand. Zip up in that core. Remember, we're gonna start with our regular row. Elbows in close. We'll take it wide. We'll pulse it at the end. Strong back. Here we go. Up and down. Breathe. Bringing that elbow up right by that side. And what we mean by flat back is just not rounding here. Eyes up. Keep breathing. Good. If you can, take it out wide. Wide. That's tougher with this heavier kettlebell, but try it. Again, you can always keep it center if that's better for you where you are. Keep breathing. Last two wide. Then let's rotate that elbow in. Little pulses. So really small range of motion, but I want you to think about squeezing in the shoulder blade. Yes. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Relax. Kettlebell down. Stretch that out. That's why this workout is called Sculpt, right? Whew. Breathe. Go ahead and come into a seated position. Let's get a little bit of core before we take it up with some cardio in between. So seated nice and tall with or without your kettlebell, whatever feels good for you. It's that Russian twist. We're gonna take it over our body. So here to here. Start with this. If you can lean back a little or lift up those feet, up to you. You can also do this with no weight at all. Here we go. Up and breathe. Good. Leaning back if you can, if that is comfortable for you, appropriate for you where you are today. Notice we're getting a little bit of biceps, which is coming up in this next circuit. If you're feeling good about it, you want to push it up in the center. Little press, it's up to you. Stay engaged. Make sure we're not pushing that core out, but we're pulling that deep core in. Four more. Four, three, two, one. Relax, stretch it over. Whew. So in between each circuit, we are gonna get one set of swings. We're gonna spread out those swings today. So I'm gonna go ahead and take my kettlebell a little heavier. I'm gonna bump it up to 20, I think. Oh, yep, wrong way. There we go. So let's take it here. We're gonna swing. If you've never done a swing before, or you're not comfortable with a swing, here's your modification. You can always just do a deadlift. Just a hinge, kettlebell right in the center. If you are able, we're gonna keep that kettlebell in the center. We're gonna prep it. We're gonna swing it back. We're keeping it chest level or below. Roll those shoulders back. We're hinging here, prep it. Three, two, one, power it up. I want you to breathe out at the top. Remember, it's a power move. So really get that power from the back of the legs. There we go. Zip up in the core. Your arms are not doing the work. They're getting the work, but they're not doing the work. We're all backloaded. Let's go. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, and relax. So kettlebell right in the center, pedal those feet, catch your breath. Quick sip of water if you need it. First circuit down, guys. It's gonna go quickly. As promised. I'm gonna go ahead and switch mine back. Ooh, let's see what we got. Sorry, I was on 12 before. I'm gonna keep it at 20. Let's just try that. We'll see how that goes. Kettlebell in the center. I'm gonna talk you through your next circuit. While I'm doing that, if you wanna do a little tap behind, touch your kettlebell or skater a little quicker, you can. If you wanna take a real break for just under a minute, you can, up to you. Little tap, slow impact, little skaters here. Watch me here. All right, our super basic squat. So toes out, you can keep it kettlebell in the center or you can flip it to that goblet squat if you wanna be here or flip the other way. Goblet squat here. We're gonna start with that. We're gonna add a little side raise, a little abduction, and then we're gonna do some pulses at the end. Then we're gonna keep it here, either holding it this way or this way, and we're gonna do some curls, right? Same thing. We're gonna curl it. We're gonna add a little press to it. We'll do some pulses at the end. I'm actually gonna go a little lighter, feeling my shoulder in that curl. So, go ahead and grab that kettlebell right in the center. Kettlebell can be low or high, up to you. Drop it down. I want you to really sit the hips low. If you can, hold it in that goblet squat. I actually love this Bowflex adjustable kettlebell for goblet holds and holding it upside down by the horns because I feel like I can get a better grip. Breathe. Good, one more just like this. Let's add a little abduction, a little side raise. So squat as we come up, lift. Squat, still get low, lift. Flex that foot. You don't have to go super high. I don't want you to lean into it. I want you to stay nice and tall. Lift from the hip and the outer thigh. Right. And breathe. Last two. One more. Yes, let's hold it down. Sit low, pulse those hips down, weight in the heels. Yes, four, three, two, one. All right, feeling that? Good work, guys. Remember, no repeat workout, so you don't have to do that again. So kettlebell either here or flipped, We're gonna go into that bicep curl. We'll start just curling towards your chest. We'll add a shoulder press and then we'll pulse it. Zip up that core, here we go. In and up. So people often ask what I mean when I say zip up that core. I just mean you wanna brace and stabilize, really pull everything in towards each other, not sucking in, not tucking, but engage while we're breathing through it. Good. We're gonna add a little press right here. So curl, press, in and down. You don't have to go super high. I don't want you to arch that back. You can press it out in front of your body. Little bend if you need to. If you got that kettlebell flip, this works too. Keep going. Up, up, down, and down. Whatever feels better for your grip is fine. Let's go one more all the way through. I want you to hold it at the biceps. Little pulses, right? Ooh, good, about the halfway mark. And then bring it up a little closer to your body. Pulse 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, relax. Woo! Stretch those thumbs back, right? Ah, hopefully you're feeling it like me. Let's take it down. Kettlebell out of the way, onto your back. Let's get a little bonus core in between. So we're gonna take it down here. If you need to modify, you can always just do leg and arm reach, take the crunch out of it. If you're able, we're here, guys. We're gonna take that leg out, reach, out, and in. Out, reach, out. Join me when you're ready. So it's a double crunch. We're crunching on the reach, and we're crunching on the in. Out, reach. Any of those options will do. Again, you can just keep it low. If you need to take the crunch out of it, we're still engaging the core. Pull everything in, knit those abs together. Breathe, keep it going, almost. Ah! Let's go four more. Three, everything coming in, two, last one, and breathe. Hug those knees in, just gentle roll side to side. Go ahead and bring it up. We're gonna set back up for a swing. I'm gonna go a little heavier, guys. Again, the reason I do this, it's actually easier to get good form with a heavier weight. I'm going 25. I'm just gonna bump it up every time. If you have an option to go heavier, try it. Otherwise, keep what you're comfortable with. Again, if you've never done a swing or you're not comfortable, you stick with just that deadlift, same set of muscles, but taking the power out of it. Here we go. Zip up that core, roll those shoulders back. We're gonna hike it like a Vabata prep. Power it up. Here we go. 3, 2, drive it to the back. Power up. I like to really breathe out. Make sure you hear that breath. That's gonna help you tighten everything at the top. As you come up, tighten in the glutes, hamstrings, lock out the knees, squeeze in the back, as well as arms and core. Here we go. 4, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Go ahead and pedal into those feet. Breathe. Whoo. Yes. Good. Kettlebell right in the center. Grab a quick sip of water. One last circuit, and some of it is on the mat, guys. So while we catch our breath, again, you can just tap it out or get a real rest. If you want a little cardio, you're gonna step out, tap down, or here, right? Any of those options, little low impact, or pick it up just a bit. You're just going side to side. We just wanna keep that heart pumping. Watch me, side lunge. Whew, I got my heavy one here, about to drop it down. We're gonna start here stationary. So we're leaning into it all on the same side. Then we'll move it to a little step and then we will pulse it. Then we're gonna take it down. I gotta go lighter, guys. Good things, this is easy to switch. We're gonna take it down to a chest press with some triceps. So we're here, we're gonna press, we're gonna add triceps, just like we added that shoulder press. We'll start with our close grip press. We'll add some triceps if you're comfortable with that, and then we'll pulse it with both at the end. Then we'll stay down, we'll get some planks for a little bit of core. Go ahead and bring it up, guys. Catch your breath, kettlebell in that opposite hand. We're gonna start just shifting our weight. Here we go. Lean into it here. So you're taking that kettlebell across your body as you drive the hips back and you shift your weight. So it looks like this. Sometimes it even helps to keep that hand out, but think drive the hips back, shift your weight, kettlebell towards the heel. Let's step into it. If you want, step in, step low, cross it over. Kettlebell towards that leg, breathe. No need to rush. Let's go four more right here. Get low, push out of that hip. Three, yes, two, one more. And let's take it down, little pulses. So I want you to lean into that hip. So think you're pulsing back into the side. Four, three, two, relax, good. Tap it out, kettlebell switches over to that other hand. We're gonna do the same thing on that other side. Hopefully you feel that heart rate, right? So breathe, take it here, take it out, weight shift. Down and up. Super simple, I want you to concentrate on the movement, driving the hips back, shifting your weight. Again, if that arm out helps, get low. Now, hopefully we're a little bit tired by now, but keep that full range of motion. Step into it, here we go. Drop it down, push out of the hip. Drop it down, yes, how are you doing? Hopefully you're feeling good. Energy's up. Muscles are working hard. Heart is pumping. Two more right here. Yes. Let's take it down. Pulse it here. So pulse. Pulse back and out. Four, three, two, relax, kettlebell in the center, pedal those feet. Whew. Go ahead and bring it down onto your back. Chest press, close grip, triceps. We'll start with the press, we'll add the tries, we'll pulse with both at the end. Breathe, if you feel more comfortable or you wanna add a little extra layer, you can take it up into a bridge in between, but remember, we still got more swings coming. So go ahead and take it here, right in the center, elbows right by your side, grip that kettlebell. We're zipping up in the core, we're pressing up. Here we go, take it up, elbows down, take it up, elbows down. So on this close grip press, you're getting a lot of chest and shoulders, but our bonus is that we're getting more triceps as well, right? It's kind of the advantage of pretty much only being able to do the close grip unless you do one side. Let's add some triceps. So up, bend towards the forehead. If you don't feel comfortable with that, I know sometimes holding that kettlebell right there, especially if your arms are tired or your hands are sweaty, you can always just do the press. Up, bend, slow and controlled. Again, bridge if you want a little extra. Take it up. Bend. There we go. Two more. Last one. Good. I want you to hold it halfway down. Little pulses up. So really feel that back of the arms. Tries. Four, three, two. And if you can, really small pulses with that kettlebell. Four, three, two. Relax. Oh, stretch those up. I know. breathe. I want you to take it over onto your side. Let's get a little side plank. So kettlebell out of the way. Ooh, you can stay on your knees. You can come all the way up. Whatever feels good for you, we're gonna sweep that arm up and over as we lift. So breathe, zip up in the core. Here we go. We're reaching up, we're taking it down. If you're on the knees, you're here, that works too. If you need extra balance, just take that sweep out of it and just lift, that works too. Reach and down. Think about lifting through that lower oblique, those side abs, and core is pulled in and engaged. Breathe. Lots of core here. Yes. Two more. Up. One more. And then how about we hold it here since we're pulsing? Little pulse down. Yes, drop that hip. Four, three, two, relax. Good. Bring it up and over. I'm always surprised that even something like a side plank or a plank gets my heart pumping because we're working. Other elbow beneath the shoulder, again on the knee or all the way up. We're gonna scoop it up and over. We'll pulse it at the end. Zip up that core. Make sure you're breathing. Here we go. Scoop it up, over, slowly down. Breathe up, over, slowly down. Use that arm to really get that stretch, right? Good. Up. If you need this hand, that works too. If you need the knee, totally fine. Breathe. Lifting from the lower oblique. So really have that core do the work. Try not to push through the elbow. Two more right here. Last one. Hold it here. Pulse it down. Drop the hip really small. Yes. Four, three, two. Relax. Good. Stretch it over. I think we got time for one more swing. Go ahead and bring it up. I'm going to go even heavier, you guys, because I want that challenge, and I love that on swings, we're able to do that. All right, 35, we'll see how it goes. You do you, whatever is best for you. If you wanna go heavier or keep it where you are, you be where you are today. Again, modification, especially if you've never done a swing, is that hinge, that deadlift. Everybody else, hold it in the center, eyes up, hike it back. Here we go, last swing. Power up, take it up, let it drop. Breathe out, really feel the floor, push into those heels. Your feet are driving the movement. Lock it out up top. You're stopping straight up and down. We're not arching that back. Here we go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, relax it down. Breathe, pedal those feet. Ha! Whew. How about a little bonus core? Then I promise we're done. Let's come into that high plank, guys. Let's take it here. Hold it here. We can't get through a workout without a plank, right? Modification, you can be on the knees here or here. Bring it up. And let's just do a little circle of our knees across. Opposite elbow and then circle across. So you're going elbow to elbow and back, elbow to elbow and back. If you're on your knees, you can do the same thing with a little extra support. Breathe, keep it going. For 8, last thing, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stretch it back. Nice work, everybody. Sit back into the hips. Reach forward. I hope you feel good and strong. Go ahead and bring it up. You can have your hands on your kettlebell or on the floor or legs. Just pedal those feet like we did before, stretching out the hamstring. I feel much more awake than I did when we started. I hope you do too. Slowly roll it up. Let's take those legs out wide. Just press out gently. Make sure you get some water, maybe some breakfast or lunch after this. Other side. Be sure to check out all of the other workouts and videos here on the Bowflex YouTube channel. I've been doing kettlebell and dumbbell alternating the last several Mondays, so there are lots of other full body 30 minute workouts. Bree is also here on Tuesdays and has some no equipment workouts. So if you don't have equipment or you just want that body weight challenge, check it out with her. And of course, don't forget to subscribe. Hips to the back. Join me next Monday. We'll be doing full body dumbbells. Go ahead and round it up. Take one arm, big stretch over. Drop into that. Of course, make sure you get some more stretches on your own. Head drop, reach those thumbs to the back. Grab if you can, or just keep pushing thumbs to the back, chin to your chest. And bring it forward here. And up, a little bit to the right. And left one more time. Whew, you did it. One big deep breath in. Thank you for showing up and moving with me. Check out all of the other Bowflex videos on this channel. Don't forget to subscribe. And I will see you guys next Monday. Have a great day, everybody.